welcome to Neutral Site Action, and we're just about ready for kickoff. And now we bring you the coin toss, and it's presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Both teams are lining up for the kickoff, and we're just about set to get this one underway. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out onto the field for the first drive of the game. Stays in bounds and made a nice catch.
He made a really good move at the line of scrimmage. Sometimes all you need to do is throw off the defender's timing just a little bit at the start of the play.
So they're going to try to determine if the receiver had possession and was inbounds or not.
After reviewing the play, the rule on the field is reversed.
Well, I know the receiver isn't too happy, but they got it right after the review. No catch. From their own 25-yard line. Second down. Throws it to the halfback on the screen. He might have a chance. And he's tackled at about the 45. They give to the tailback. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 35. And that'll be a gain of 10 by the running back. Taken down at the 31. 4-yard gain, and that'll be a first down.
Nothing special here. Quick pass and a good catch, but it keeps the chains moving.
And I think it was the quick throw by the quarterback that fouled up the defense on that one. Passes to his tailback again. They bring him down in the backfield. They lose 3 yards there.
They really just didn't have any room to work on that play. The defense just suffocated him there.
It's second down now, 13 to go. Ball on the 34. And they're going to put 6 DBs on the field to counter that 5 receiver look.
Saw something upstairs. It led to a touchdown. You can thank the play calling there. Very impressive.
And he adds the extra point. A nice 7-play, 75-yard drive. And they come away with 7 points.
Brad, I love these kind of drives. They're old school. Grind it out and earn the yards and rip the heart right out of that defense.
It looks like they're ready for the kickoff. Nice kick, plenty of distance. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The Rebels, in talking with them this week, Kirk, it's just interesting their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'd be shocked if they can slow him down.
They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
Back five, back nine.
throw to the tight end. Tackles at the 42.
Job by the offensive line to pick up the linebacker on the blitz. That gave the quarterback enough time to find his man for a nice game.
Back five, easy, easy.
With the pass, incomplete.
There was just no way anybody could catch up with that pass.
From the 39-yard line, second down.
Anything you can do without being penalized to prevent the offense from moving forward is always a plus.
Sets up a screen. Tailback's got it. Good tackle there in space. A 7-yard pickup on the screen play.
It's a well-designed play to the halfback, and it worked at least to get them a medium gain on the play.
It's fourth down, and they're going to try to go for it. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. Quick throw, and they make the stop around the 25-yard line. That play could not have come at a better time.
That was absolutely the perfect time to go with that play on fourth down.
He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line.
Textbook coverage by the defense. That's exactly what you want to do on every single pass play, but it doesn't always happen.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. Fires that quickly, incomplete. Kicks away, and it sails through the uprights. Ole Miss kicked this one off. Excellent kick. He's to the 20. Loose football. It's scooped up. Tackle at the 32-yard line. It's first and 10. Ball on the 32. Mississippi State is up by 4.
Oklahoma.
Makes it out to about the 43. It out to about the 44-yard line.
That makes it second and 10.
Fires quickly to the tight end. He's taken down at the 46.
That's good for a gain of 2 yards. That makes it third and 7.
Setting up play action. He gets the pass away. And down he goes, the 24-yard line. First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 24-yard line. On the ground, inside. Tackle outside after a nice pickup.
That brings in
Mississippi State holds a four-point lead. And they get nice yardage on that run. Second and six. 8 yards out. With a carry. They'll drop him for a loss. Splits the uprights with the extra point. A 10-play, 67-yard drive. And the result, 7 points.
Brad, that's one of those drives that can just tear your heart up. It can really demoralize the defense when they drive the ball down the field, and a lot of the yards came on the ground.
So our score, 14-3. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. Zips it to the tight end. They'll bring him down around the 32-yard line. Big opening. Very good tackle in space. For a nice game. And we've reached the end of one. 14-3, Bulldogs. Back to the action now here in the second quarter. He's got the corner. Nice run, and he's brought down. After a decent pickup. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
Gain of 4 yards. That makes it second and six.
Throws complete. He's got room to work. Looks like he flinched down there on the line. They'll line up for another third down play because of the penalty.
Well, here you're in a third down situation, and then someone makes a mental mistake. It makes your blood boil if you're a coach.
Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 34. He makes a catch and has a first down. Made the 19-yard line. This guy just made those 10 yards look easy. And he makes gets it out to about the 17-yard line. It to the five.
That makes it first and goal.
Kill, kill, kill!
And he's tackled at the three. This is the 14th play of the drive. Touchdown, Mississippi. And he tacks on the extra point. Kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. He's to the 20. At the 30. Down the sideline. And they finally tackle him at the 34-yard line.
Not sure what the flag is about here. Let's go down to the field and find out.
Receiving team.
So they'll move back after that costly penalty, and they'll have to try to get that yardage back here.
There hasn't been too much daylight between these two teams. In games like this, some players try to press too much, and that can cause mistakes.
Mississippi State is up four. Strike to his receiver, no good. He tried to hit his receiver in stride, but overthrew it a little too much.
That'll come in time. Just repetition, throwing that same pass over and over, and he'll be fine.
From their own 16-yard line, second down.
Setting up blockers, the running back's got it on the screen. They'll work the left side. He has some room. He makes his way to about the 45.
Drops the ball here. I don't know if he starts to peek downfield and think about the return or what, but that ball's right in his hands. He just dropped it.
It's second and 10. Ball on the 45. Pulls it in, and he's in the open field. Right down at the 31-yard line. Mississippi State is up by four. Throws it, and he's got the tight end again. He's tackled around the 19-yard line. From the 19-yard line, it's first down. Inside the 10, Nice play to set up first and goal. 10th play of the drive. The Bulldogs call a timeout. That's their second of the half.
Here we go.
Tackled for a loss. They're crowding the line. Touchdown, Bulldogs. And he hits the PAT. Kick this one away. Sends it sailing downfield. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
I think any good football team has to have an ability to answer, and that's exactly what we just saw. One team scores a touchdown, the other team comes right back and puts another touchdown on the board. This is getting exciting.
You think about the challenges these two teams are facing. On one side, you've got to find a way to keep building on your lead, and on the other side, you've got to find a way to get back in it. And he hits him hard at the 33.
What impresses me so much is the guy's vision. He read the coverage perfectly to find his man for good yardage.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback, and they make the stop at the 40. So they complete that for about 7 yards, and they'll pick up a first down.
Nice protection, a good pass, and even a better catch. You can't ask for much more than that.
When you've got a quarterback making throws that quickly, the defense doesn't have a lot of time to react to the play. He's taken down at the 39-yard line.
He looked pretty cool back there. Even with the outside linebacker blitzing, he made an accurate throw, and the result is a new set of downs.
Stays in bounds to make a nice catch.
It's a great job here by the quarterback of recognizing the outside linebacker blitz and delivering the football for a first down.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. Nice job getting a hand on that one.
Yeah, really good heads-up play there to get a hand on the football by the defense.
That makes it 7-10.
He might want it all here and does. Can't connect. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time. And he'll get the next one.
Third down, and they need to get it to the 15. And he tackles him hard at the 5-yard line.
Not a real fancy play here, just a smartly run route, good protection, and a well-placed ball. Most times, you don't need much more than that.
Trying to get it to the tight end, but it falls to the ground. This is the 10th play of this drive. Throws it and it's caught for the touchdown. Gets it through the air.
Yeah, they've had some success in their short passing game, so they felt confident they could make that play work down inside the 10.
And he converts the extra point. A 9-play, 75-yard drive, and a touchdown as a result.
Brett, I thought the key to that drive really had a lot to do with the quarterback and the receivers getting in sync, making it very tough for the defense to slow them down.
He's to the 20. Brought down at the 23-yard line. Momentum swings have been fairly even. And with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Mississippi State holds a 4-point lead. I'd say the offensive coordinators definitely showed their wares in that first half. The Bulldogs lead 21-17.
We played 30 minutes. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. David Pollack and I here in the studio to break down everything that just happened in your game. Take a look at both quarterbacks in this game, and neither one of them even has their pants dirty. Nobody's been on the ground here. No pressure generated by the defense, but one of the reasons is because quarterbacks have been able to get rid of the football. Maybe a little help in the secondary to those guys trying to rush the pass.
The guys up front always get the blame, but it really is a business that works hand in hand, because you can get a lot of sacks off garbage sacks where it's great coverage down the field, but the quarterback has to hold it for 4 or 5 seconds. But it works the other way around too. If somebody's open every time he pats that football and reaches the top of his drop, I can't get there in time. So the coverage needs to tighten up a little bit, mess up the rhythm, jam the receivers maybe a little bit more. Give me a little bit of time so those big boys up front can get to the quarterback.
I can only hope that Nessler and Herbstreit will bring the same type of intensity to their call of the second half that David and I brought to the halftime show. Of course, they always do. That's it for us here in the studio. Time to get you back out to the guys for the second half.
All right, Reese and David, thanks, guys. Second half action just about ready to start here. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. They give to the tailback. Makes it out to about the 33. And down he goes, right around the 36-yard line. He goes out of bounds, right around the 40. Their own 36-yard line. It's third down. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. The offense is on its way out on the field again, and they haven't had any problem finding the end zone in their past couple of drives. Mississippi State is up four. Has some daylight. He's at midfield. He gets it out to about the 47-yard line. He gets out to about the 45-yard line. Catches it, and he's looking for more. Throws quick to the receiver, and it falls incomplete.
Number six is the
from the 34-yard line. It's second down.
White out here truly knows what he has to do to contribute to make his team successful.
One of the things a quarterback's looking for before the ball is snapped on a post route is to see if he has one safety in the middle of the field. Because with one safety, you can use your eyes to move that safety and then throw back the other way for the touchdown. I thought the quarterback that time did a really good job of managing that safety and eventually making the throw for the touchdown.
Well, I think the play warranted a review, but the call on the field stands. He splits the uprights with the extra point. Looks like they're ready for the kick. And he got all of this one. Great kick. The offense is looking to be a little bit more successful with this drive as they had to punt the ball away the last time they had it.
If they're going to make a comeback in this game, it's going to have to start now. This offense has to get rolling.
He gets out to about the 28-yard line. The back gets three on the carry.
Nice play here by the senior to make the sure tackle. It's not very often that someone's able to shake this guy.
He is drilled at the 27-yard line. He's at midfield, and down he goes at the 49. 6 points and a pretty display of passing was a result of their last drive. Kirk, do you expect the defense to take a different approach here?
When this quarterback is on, he is on. It already seems like whatever this defense is trying just isn't working. But maybe if they add just a little bit more pressure, then they might be able to force him into a mistake.
Defense coming through and creating some breaks, which is exactly what the safety did.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Makes the catch, and look out. Here he goes. He makes his way to about the 22. He might play ever developed nicely.
Well, it's all about the receiver on this play. He beat his man off the line and then ran a perfect route. All he had to do after that was make the catch.
And he adds the extra point. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. This offense lost the ball by way of a fumble the last time they had it.
The first rule on offense is to take care of the football. These guys need to remember that on this drive.
Counter, right side. That's a great tackle at the 37. Mississippi State is up by four. And he's taken down at the 32.
If this offense keeps running at this guy, they're going to have to rethink some of their play calling.
From their own 32-yard line, second down. Gains his way to the 43-yard line. Got an opening. Gains his way to the 49-yard line. From the 49-yard line, first down. The 40. Gains his way to the 33-yard line. Got an opening. Tackle at the 24-yard line.
Great display of offense by both teams so far. As we head to the fourth, Mississippi State leads it 28-24.
Welcome back to the action here as we resume play here in quarter number four. Mississippi State holds a four-point lead. And they get nice yardage on that run. Right down around the 2-yard line. He makes the PAT. They line up to kick this one away. He kicks it off, and he got all of that one. He's to the 20. Across the 30. Tackle at the 33-yard line. These guys came up with a touchdown on their last drive, and they'll be hoping for another six on the board here. He lets it fly, and it's intercepted. And he's tackled at the 42.
It's a good play when a corner can break up a pass, but it's even better when he can bring it in for an interception.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 42. Sacked for a loss.
That's a loss of 2 yards on the play. That brings us 3rd and 12.
Third down, and they need to get it down to the 32. Wants it all, going long. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Number 4, the intended receiver. That makes it 4th and 12.
Let's see if he aims for the sideline and tries to get this thing down deep in their own territory. He puts it away, and it's a great kick. This punt goes over the goal line, and this will be a touchback. The quarterback comes back on the field, and I'm sure he's hoping to make up for that interception on the last drive.
I look for the offense to come out with the same game plan as before. You don't make changes after one play.
Fires out to his wide, and they make the stop at the 33. It to the 44.
That makes it 1st and 10.
Kill.
3, 15.
Here's an opening.
That brings him 2nd and 1.
Trying to set up a little screen, gets it to his tailback. So it's 3rd down now, and they're going to need about 4. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Gets it. He's in space. He's tackled the 37-yard line. Quick throw, and he's got his man again. He's taken down at the 14-yard line.
You can't take sacks like that as a quarterback. You just can't. If you can't find a receiver, get out of the pocket and throw the ball away.
Defense looking for another sack in this 2nd down and long situation. Delivers to the halfback on the screen. And down he goes around the 20-yard line.
That'll bring up 39.
There was some movement on the line.
False start. Offense.
They'll give this one another try after the flag.
And on 3rd down, too. That's when you don't want those kind of things to happen.
So with the penalty, they've got 3rd and a mile.
Three down. Mike Stiffy.
the sack.
The protection broke down. The defense was in the backfield in a hurry, and they brought the quarterback down. Nice play.
Just under two to go in the game. Kicks away, and he splits the uprights.
That one looked like cake for this kid. Chalk up 3 points for the offense.
The score now, Mississippi State 35, Ole Miss 27. Tackle made at the 41. And they could not recover the onside kick.
Well, it's a nice job there by the return team to recover the football. Now they just want to run the clock out.
You know this is a real crucial time in the game. It could still go either way. Makes it out to maybe the 40-yard line. Pickup of a yard for the tailback.
Great play by the senior linebacker to step up in traffic and make that tackle.
Second and eight. Ball on the 40-yard line. Gains his way to the 30-yard line.
Good solid running right there. Getting past the defensive lineman and into the secondary before he could be stopped.
Here we go.
He makes it out to maybe the 30-yard line. Maybe a yard on the run by the tailback.
The sophomore just stuck it to the ball carrier right there. That's a very good tackle.
Second down and 10 to go. Ball on the 30. He fights forward to about the 30. The quarterback trying to do a little too much by himself.
Hey, maybe next time he'll get it out to the back so he can do something with it.
He's hit and taken down. That's a loss of 4 yards.
That play was sort of out of sync from the start, but you have to also recognize that the defense made a great play. They read it from the get-go.
They'll call on the field goal unit. A little over a minute in the game. Kick is up. It's got the distance. And he just drilled it from long range. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. Excellent kick. They'll bring him down at the 18. I'm sure there are a lot of fans out there hoping for a miracle, but I seriously doubt we're going to see one today. He's got it with room to run. And he's level at the 23-yard line. And he stops the clock with a spike. It's third down and 5 to go. Ball on their own 23. Crosses out to the tailback on the screen. They'll bring him down at the 43-yard line. Spikes the ball.
Second and 10.
From their own 43-yard line, second down. He's going to air it long. Grabs it and he might go the distance. And he's all the way in for the touchdown. Late in the fourth quarter now, and with that score, this game's a one-possession ball game, and it's really going to get tense from here on out. So the offense is going to go for two. Here we are late in the fourth quarter in a very important and a very tight football game. And who's going to come to the forefront? We'll see who's got the most leadership. He wants it all. He goes up, picked off. Mississippi State 38, Ole Miss 35. Kirk, go ahead and just give us your reflections on this game.
Nothing adds to the pageantry of college football more than a good rivalry. This was a great game that should only add more fuel to the fire for next year's matchup, and boy, was it fun to watch.
Sports and Kirk Herbstreit. This is Brad Nessler saying thanks for tuning in, and we'll see you next time.